Or it could be that I was talking myself for the last 5 minutes. I see a little red dot blinking. See, I didn't bother to get my magnifying glass and look at it. It just now started recording. I've been going on for 5 minutes. So, yeah, that's when I need to be able to see anything, hardly anymore. Got my glasses on it. Okay, so this is a test of 48 megapixels in 4K, but I had the last time I recorded with this, I had it's called anti-shake turned on, and everything looked, you could see all the pixels, you could see the dots, and you could tell it didn't look, and it looks a little fuzzy. Everything has a fuzz around it. It's almost kind of like it's outlined with something, you know, your hands, your face, everything. It didn't look good. It was kind of like it was outlined with darker dots than your face or the background, you know. And it was shot, that video was shot in here with the light pretty similar to what it is now. It's not. And the background will be kind of close, too close really. That doesn't work well within about in there on. It won't focus any closer than that. But I can really see it now because I have a 4K TV I'm using for my computer monitor. And it's a good one, so anyway, and this one, this camera, it doesn't have a 4K sensor. It has a 13 megapixel sensor. It can't actually do real 4K video. What they do is they use up converting software on the in the camera itself, try to bump up the megapixels to where, you know, you can go anywhere. This thing, you can set it. I finally found the settings when I was going on about how to get in there. Anyway, you can set it anywhere from 1.5 megapixels to 48 megapixels. And the way I figured out how to get in there, you can hit the mode button. There's a menu and a mode. You hit the mode button on the remote, and it seems to page through. There seems to be three different places you go in there, and then one of them, and I really don't know other than when I hit the menu. One of them, you hit the menu, and you'll get just what I knew from the beginning. You had a resolution, or the word resolution in there. You click on that, go in there, and all you could do is pick between, you know, anything from 4K, which you didn't know what megapixels you're getting in. I don't think it was getting, you know, 48. I'm almost certain it wasn't. All the way down to SD standard definition. But if you go on in one of the other mode spots and hit it, you'll still see resolution, and you'll see pretty much the same words in the top three to five menus. But actually, there's a whole lot more, I think, in this one. And when you go into resolution, you can actually pick a megapixel. So that's just really crazy the way that's set up. And I just found it by accident. I read that manual. I don't think they had a PDF manual, they had a paper one. But I poured over it with my old magnifying glass. Never did figure it out. I just figured it out by accident, mashing around on the buttons, trying to figure out how to. I couldn't remember how to do something I wanted to do, and I got in there. So anyway, I'm going to stop here. And sound's going to be terrible because I'm using the onboard mic, and I was just trying to hurry up and do a video.